I'm Sheena Quick with Black Sports Online and Out of the Blocks. I'm here with Jeff Johnson after that amazing panel. It was amazing. Like, I've been coming here for 3 years. That's the best panel.
No, it was amazing. It was still too many people on the panel, but it was a dope conversation. No, I mean, there were so many people. You could add another 2 hours to get all the content out of that.
That's a half day type thing. So let me ask you, coming from a particular standpoint, I am a young black female in sports media. And some of the things you said about your family, it kind of stood out to me because I'm in a predicament where I cover the Carolina Panthers. They're a very conservative team. You know, Jerry Richardson was one of the few owners that didn't really speak out when Donald Trump made those inflammatory remarks. And just coming from where I am, I'm usually the only woman in the press box or the only black woman in the press box or wherever I am. But I do sit down, or not sit down, but I do not stand for the anthem. I have my own particular reasons. It started way before this. And, you know, like I said, it's not about the anthem. I think we've kind of gotten lost in that. What are some of your suggestions as far as someone that's in my predicament where you're kind of trying to do your job as far as reporting on the sports and things like that, but this is something that cannot be ignored.
But what impact do you want to make?
I want to give pure, unadulterated journalism when it comes to entertainment and when it comes to sports, and that means the good, the bad, and the ugly. I want to give you the statistics on the field, but I also want to give you the politics behind it.
Sure. But I guess I mean from the standpoint of your protest. So if you're protesting, at some point, that protest should have some level of impact. And a lot of times, we do protest that's symbolic, but it doesn't have impact.
Exactly.
And we will risk, unnecessarily, opportunity in the name of a ceremonial act, as opposed to being more strategic and using our protest to actually have impact.
And that's what I'm asking you, like, what's the strategy that you could offer me?
But that's why I asked, what are you trying to impact?
I'm definitely trying to impact this world that my boys are growing up in, you know, my cousins.
But I mean specifically, right? So like so I have 18-year-old, 15-year-old, 14-year-old, and a 6-month-old. Yeah. And I know that there are key things that I want to impact. So I care about how do we change the law that says police officers are able to use their own discretion at what level of force they're able to use and how they determine threat. So that's a specific impact I want to make. Because I recognize the reason these cats get off is not always because of bad prosecution, it's because the law gives them the ability to do that. So I just think we have to get more specific in our impact, because once we are specific about the impact, it dictates what we do.
And do you feel like that, I guess, lack of specificity hurts the actual subjects that are being protested in the NFL? Do you think some people are kneeling or just getting in on this argument and this fight without getting to the root of why Colin was kneeling?
I do. Well, and I think it was never about Colin.
Right.
So that's the problem. Colin never asked the truth to be about Colin.
He didn't.
So he took a stand and we made it about him instead of what he was taking a stand for.
Exactly.
And that's where it automatically got lost. So the reason that happens often is because we don't have institutional infrastructure that are mobilization organizations or campaigns that says we're going to have 3 people, all they do is work on this. They're going to develop messaging around this, they're going to develop imagery around this, they're going to develop strategy around this, they're going to be clear about what the deliverables are, they're going to be clear about what the targets are. Now people have somewhere to plug into, versus people plugging into everybody's damn social media with no instruction.
Right. So you think social media helps and hurts, obviously. What are some of the ways that people can use their social media? Like you said, they have to be specific and it has to be something that's effective as opposed to just being
ceremonial. So here's the thing. I think people should use social media for what they want. And I think some people are just sharing their opinion.
Right.
But people who really want to make an impact, there's a way to do that, and it's institutional.
Right.
So I think those who care enough need to begin creating the institutional infrastructure and deliverables to be systematic.
Yeah, but
right.
And if we're not, you can't defeat an enemy that is diabolically systematic, arbitrary.
Right, right. So like with Jerry Jones telling his team what they had, basically taking away their First Amendment right, do you feel like, I guess for me.
But did he take away their First Amendment right, or did he give them a choice?
He did give them a choice. It was kind of a.
No, it's bullshit.
I mean, kind of a quit or be fired type thing.
Well, not quit or be fired. Stand or don't play.
Right.
And so there's a difference even from a labor law standpoint. So I never heard him say you won't get paid.
You'll get paid, but you won't hit that field. Later.
Right. So he's not violating your rights because you're still getting paid.
Right.
He just treating you like a slave.
$40 million.
And so we've gotta navigate again, what are we saying to Jerry Jones? What are we saying to the league by way of rules? What are we asking for? Because now it seems like we're fighting for the right to kneel.
Right.
And
just to be able to.
Why the hell are we fighting for the right that we already have? For me, the question is, what are the larger asks? And I was always concerned that why is the sum total of whether we win or not if one guy gets a contract that makes another white guy rich? So if Colin Kaepernick gets a contract, he still makes an owner more money.
He does.
So Colin gets a job, great, woo-hoo. But there's an owner who's now selling more jerseys, selling more seats, and is making more money. That damn sure is not the goal,
right,
as far as I'm concerned.
Right.
Why are we not saying, NFL, the next time there is an available team, you have to have a minority-owned group that you sell to, period. Not in the bunch. No, you got to have three minority groups. You choose the one that has the best package, period. Because if we're not talking about ownership and equity, if we're not talking about power, then we just playing.
Right. And that's one of the things that I noticed between hip-hop and sports. Hip-hop, there's a lot more minority ownership in our own content, our own channels, our own networks, and things like that. And you see so little of that when it comes to professional sports.
But it's a different cost of entry.
Right.
I mean, building a platform costs as much as it takes for you to build a platform. A team costs anywhere up to $1 billion. So it's just a different level of entry.
Do you think that that's a possible level of entry, or one that should be looked into?
That's what I'm saying. I think the ask should be about ownership.
Okay.
And I think that there's enough people that can put the kind of groups together to afford it.
Okay. Now, I actually cover NASCAR as well as...
And I got to run out of this question.
Oh, yeah, we're going to wrap it up. I actually cover NASCAR as well, and it's interesting because the owners put out that statement, you know, saying what they had to do and what the consequences would be for if people were to, you know, disrespect the flag, so to speak. But on the other flip side of that, I actually covered the Drive for Diversity campaign, where they're trying to get more diverse drivers in. Do you feel like that's just something they're kind of doing to placate with the message that they're trying, or do you think they're actually trying to?
I think that they are trying to get a minority audience, so they can get minority money.
Capitalistic society, I mean.
No, and there's been a lot of people who have said, how do we diversify NASCAR? How do we have black folks that become owners of teams? That conversation's been happening for quite a while,
right.
I think, as you well know. But I think listen, all of these are businesses, and at the end of the day, they want our money, but they don't care about us. They just care about our money. I don't know why we're pretending like they should.
They never have.
But why would they? Tell me a company that in their mission is to care about people. So there are some social impact companies that have been created that have a double or triple bottom line impact methodology.
Right.
The vast majority of companies, especially public traded companies, their sole mission is to get value to shareholders.
Right.
So people used to ask me all the time, how did I feel about being at BET and BET not doing enough of this or enough of that? I'm like, Deborah Lee, when she goes into a shareholder meeting, they're not asking how many kids did you teach to read. They're not asking how many kids did you inspire. They're not asking how much positive hip hop. They're saying, where is the share price?
Right. And how can it go up?
Period. That's right. It. But so if we know that, why are we expecting them to be some altruistic kind of organism that cares about the embedment of the community? The question for us is, how do we use them to effectively push messages? And then how do we create opportunities where you can immerse positivity in market viable content? Because if you don't make, when Team Summit went off the air, it was the lowest rated show in the history of the network. Lowest rated show in the history of the network.
That's surprising.
But that's why it went off. It didn't go off because they didn't want positivity on the air. It went off because
it didn't make sense. It didn't make sense. is financially, right?
So if people, you think that if it was getting a million views, they'd be like, oh no, we don't want to do this positive stuff, take it off. No. Because that million viewers would have been driving advertisers that gave them money, that gave them market share, that allowed them to say to their shareholders, we're winning.
Right.
And so if we care about content, we got to support that content. But we got to play the money game. If we're not playing the money game, we just play. We're playing checkers and they're playing chess.
I feel like we're more in a position now than we were like in the 50s or 60s, obviously, because just how things have expanded and grown and the opportunities that African Americans and other minorities have created for ourselves and opportunities to be taken advantage of. So basically, you think the power is in the pocketbook. We have to hit them financially, own our own content, gain some ownership, and then we can actually utilize, and, well, we'll be in a better position to utilize our power to force the change that we're waiting for somebody else to make for us.
I think the economic piece is a critical weapon and not the only weapon. I just play chess. So politics is a necessary weapon. Economics is a necessary weapon. Grassroots mobilization is a necessary weapon. Communications and media is a necessary weapon. Education is a necessary weapon. You remove any one of those weapons and your army is less prepared to fight. So as opposed to saying, well, we gotta start with education. No, motherfuckers who are supposed to do education. Right. The people that are supposed to do media. The people who are supposed to do finance. The people that do what you have been called to do. We got so many people trying to step into other people's calls and then wonder why the stuff they were supposed to do didn't get done.
Because you left it.
So, I don't know. I don't know if that's helpful.
It is. Thank you so much for your time.
It's
your
my pleasure.
Insight is definitely
I'm sorry,
valued.
I got a little passionate there.
No, it's okay. That's why I definitely wanted to talk to you because you're passionate about what you're saying. You're not just, you know, putting words together.
And I just spent 2 hours letting other people talk.
You did. You let wrong people talk. They lined up so quick. I had no chance. I was like, I'll get him upstairs.
But
thank you so much.
All right, sis. And I